brought to you by Fleischmann's Margarine. So light and delicate tasting because it's made from 100% corn oil. And now let's all play What's My Line? And now from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
A young man who's just returned from Africa from making a picture called Marrakesh, Mr. Tony Randall.
As ever, it's a joy to introduce the liveliest girl on my block, Arlene Francis.
And now a gentleman who has compiled one of the funniest books of the year. Something in it for everybody to laugh about, and it's called Laugh Day. And the man is Bennett Cerf.
Well, here's that big, big cheese from that famous prep school up in New Hampshire, known to his friends as the Stilton from Tilton, John Charles Day.
Bennett, I'll have a hard time living that down up at Tilton School, but still, I'm going to return kindness for that unkind thrust. We're proud of you because Arlene has already noted that Bennett's new book, Laugh Day, was published 2 weeks ago by Doubleday, but also this week on Thursday, he goes to William Jewell College in Liberty, Missouri, where they're going to give him an honorary doctorate of letters. And congratulations, sir.
Thank you.
Honorary doctorate of jokes they ought to have for you, Bennett.
I'll take that, too.
Because we'll have to assume if he's getting an honorary doctorate of letters, he's going to have to learn to write, because I guess you have to write letters. Well, that'll take care of that. Tony Randall, it's a delight to see you again on the panel, and I think that you'll agree when it's all over that we've got an interesting night for you. We're going to have our interesting occupations. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the program. But right now, our first contestant, will you enter and sign in, please? Spoony. Sink, right, sir? And Mr. Sing, I can tell from your dress, sir, and your turban, that you are sick, am I right?
That's correct.
You are sick. Could you tell us where you're from now?
I'm from Hollywood.
From Hollywood.
Right.
Well, nice to have you with us. Mr. Singh, may I present our panel?
You do.
And now will you join me over here, sir, and we will let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Mr. Singh is self-employed and he deals in a service, and we'll begin things with Arlene Francis.
Mr. Singh, is your service one that I might enjoy?
I think so.
Does it have anything whatsoever to do with food?
No, it doesn't.
1 out of 9 to go, Mr. Cerf.
Mr. Singh, since you're established in Hollywood, are your services used by the motion picture or television industries at any time?
Sometimes.
But they can also be used by people who are not in those allied arts.
That's
Is that
right.
correct?
That's right.
Does the service that you perform involve touching people in any way?
No, it doesn't.
2 out of 8 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Do you speak to them?
Not very often.
Not as a... It isn't necessary.
What kind of an answer is that?
Mr. Singh is antisocial, and it's very nice of him to admit it here, but it's not germane to what he actually does. The service he performs does not require that he
That's
speak
all right.
to them.
Give me a no, John.
3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Randall.
Mr. Singh, you're a remarkably robust man.
Thank you.
Does your powerful physique have anything to do with your services?
No, it doesn't.
4 down and 6 to go, Miss Francis.
When you perform these services, are you indoors?
Yes.
Do people come to you for your service?
Yes, they do.
Are they better off as a result of your service?
I like to think so.
We would have to agree that in a general sense, this would be the natural expectation. Since they sought the service, and having found it, I'm quite sure, satisfactory in every way, they would carry away some sense of well-being.
Is there anything physical about what happens to the people that come to you for your service?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Sir.
Well, Mr. Singh, if there's nothing physical, is there anything mental involved in contact between you and your customers?
I believe so.
There
would be some interplay, which we would describe generally, Bennett, as an appreciation of the service that was being bestowed.
Mr. Singh, is anything involving anything like hypnotism or extrasensory perception?
No, there isn't.
Mind reading in
no,
what you do?
No.
That's six down and four to go, Miss Kilgallen.
But Mr. Singh, you will agree that something does go on that makes these people come to you.
Well, we'll agree there's a good reason for the people to come and utilize the service which Mr. Singh has to offer them.
And yet he is self-employed.
That's right.
So they're not coming to a judge or anything like that. So they come, do they come of their own volition?
Yes, they do.
Are you dressed as you are now when you see them?
On some occasions, yes.
But that doesn't play any part in your work, may I assume that?
At some times it does.
Well, if you don't talk to them, you can't teach them. Do you hand them anything?
No, I don't.
That's seven down and three to go, Mr. Randall.
Is special training required for the performance of your service?
No.
Eight down and two to go, Miss Francis.
Is there anything in any way entertaining about what you do?
I think so.
Is music associated with what you do in any way?
Yes.
Yes, we would agree that there is music in connection. This is not to suggest that.
But it is not that Mr. Singh himself plays a musical
right.
instrument.
There's music in connection with it, just
I
as
see.
A matter of presentation.
When you do what you do, do people watch you?
No.
Mm-hmm, that's a tough one. This raises an area of... We will agree that in the total service involved, there is a... If you will permit this, in the total service involved, watching plays a part, looking plays a part. So you go on that basis.
Is there something therapeutic in your work?
No therapeutics. Nine down and one to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Singh, we've left out animals. Have you anything whatever to do with animals?
Nothing to do with animals, and the panel has been stumped. Mr. Singh owns and operates the Hollywood Wax Museum.
Isn't that part of the entertainment world?
We agreed. We said it was entertainment.
He said
it was
associated with entertainment.
This is the New York Wax Museum.
This is the New York Wax Museum, right over here on my right. But it's right on Hollywood Boulevard, right?
That's right.
What do you feature in the Hollywood? Is it mostly movie stars, or do you...
About 60% of it is movie stars, and then we've got religious figures, world leaders, and we've got a tremendous horror chamber that really appeals to the children. It's a variety show, that's about what it is.
Mm-hmm. A variety show in wax. Yeah, they're very popular. I guess Madame Tussauds in London is the most famous, you would agree
with
that.
That's right, yes.
But they have one in Washington, we're going to have one here in New York. Mr. Singh has one in Hollywood, and I have one right here on the stage with me. Thank you very much, Mr. Singh. It's very nice to have you with us. We'll have another contestant in just a moment after this word.
Let's visit Standard Brand's world of fine foods and go to a sunny cornfield.
From fields of sun-ripened corn comes light, delicious, Fleischmann's margarine. Fleischmann's, lowest in saturated fat of the nation's leading margarines. Of these, only Fleischmann's is made from 100% corn oil, with almost a cup of liquid corn oil in every pound. And Fleischmann's has the light, delicate flavor you want. Remember, only Fleischmann's is lowest in saturated fat of the nation's leading margarines.
Here's a loaded question for men only.
Who could we hire to talk your wife into serving Chase and Sanborn coffee? A movie star? A talking tiger? A big brass band? Ha! All she has to do is try us. Because if she hasn't tasted our coffee lately, she doesn't know about the extra flavor in instant Chase and Sanborn, a new, heftier blend. What's the heftier all about? She'll find out.
And now would our next contestant enter and sign in, please.
Catherine W. Stone. All right. Is it Miss or Mrs. Stone?
Mrs.
Mrs. Stone, and where are you from?
Madisonville, Kentucky.
Madisonville, Kentucky.
Yes.
Nice to have you with us. Mrs. Stone, may I present the panel? Now, if you'll join me over here, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is.
Thank you.
All right. We can tell you, Waxworks, that Mrs. Stone is salaried and deals in a product, and I think we'll begin with Tony Randall.
Mrs. Stone, is this a useful product?
Yes, sir.
Is it a product that is found in the home?
No, sir.
No. $1.09 to go, Miss Francis.
Is it a product that is now or ever has been alive?
Nope. $2.08 to go, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. Stone, is your product used by human beings rather than animals?
Yes, sir.
Is it consumable?
Yes, sir.
Is it eaten?
No, sir.
No, sir. That's $3.07 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Then when you say consumable, you just mean worn out.
Used up.
Worn down or used up.
Used up. Mm-hmm.
Is it used up by human beings?
Yes,
rather
sir.
Than
mm-hmm.
animals.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Is it found outside the home?
Yes.
Out of doors?
Yes.
In the open air?
Yes, sir.
Is it larger than a bread box?
No. I don't. It's never. I wouldn't think so.
Even a tiny bread box?
No, not even a little tiny bread box. That's $4.06 to go, Mr. Randall.
I'm afraid I need a little clarification. Is this used by human beings?
Right.
Yes.
And used up by human beings in its consumption?
Right.
Yes, sir.
Is it made of metal?
No.
You mean metal specifically? We would say no.
No.
You were not asking in terms of animal, vegetable, mineral. You were is it made specifically
metal.
Of
yes.
metal? No. $5.05 to go, Miss Francis.
Is it made of anything that grows?
Well, now, I would say no, wouldn't you?
No?
No. $6.40 to go, Mr. Sir.
Not made of
a
Mrs. Stone, is there anything dangerous about the product that you make?
Yes.
Might it be considered some form of firearms?
No, we couldn't call it firearms, Ben. It's $7.03 to go, but congratulations, Miss Kilgallen.
However, Mrs. Stone, would it do a lot of damage and make a lot of noise?
It could.
Yes, sir.
Would it be in the dynamite family?
Yeah, it would be in the dynamite family.
Is it dynamite?
Yeah, that's dynamite. That's what we were talking about here, that dynamite.
I don't know anybody else in the dynamite family.
What do you think Mrs. Stone does with dynamite?
I think that Mrs. Stone sells dynamite.
You're absolutely right. Nicely done. Benedict, you opened the door on that. I knew we were finished because as attractive and lovely a lady as Mrs. Stone, you would hardly ever think of being a dynamite salesman, but
she
Mrs.
Looks
Stone
like dynamite herself.
She's dynamite herself.
How do you sell it, Mrs.
She
Stone?
She was
door to door.
She's with the Atlas Powder Company, and she goes around to
goes around to coal mines and quarries and contractors and says, how's the dynamite supply today, fella? Huh? And he says, well, I shot most of it off last week. And says, I'll let you have a bit more.
She's a polar dynamite man.
Yeah. Real. Actually, you started in the road business,
yes,
and learned about explosives there, and now is a dynamite salesman. That keeps you jumping.
Yeah.
Yeah. There you go from dynamite, TNT, and then on up to nuclear fission.
Yeah.
Maybe, hope not.
I hope not. We stay where we are. Well, thank you very much, ma'am.
Yes.
It was nice to have you
with
us.
Nice meeting you, sir.
Good to see you. We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, this message.
Do you still think the nicest thing about Suppo's stockings is what they do for your legs? Well, just wait till you see what Suppo's does for your ego. New Suppo's sheerness. New Suppo's colors. Do things for your spirits that shouldn't be kept waiting. Suppo's stockings. Great for your ego.
And now the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery challenger, for which my friends on the panel, as you know, are always blindfolded. Blindfolds in place, panel?
Yes,
yes, sir.
Good. Will you enter mystery challenger and sign in, please? Panel, as you know, in the case of our mystery guest, one question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and we will begin things with Bennett Cerf.
Well, those wolf calls from the audience usually mean that the mystery guest is a young lady. Are you?
Yes.
Miss Kilgall.
Is your real first name Norma?
No.
1 down and 9 to go, Mr. Randall.
Are you one person?
I sure am.
Miss Francis?
Are you in a picture that is about to open or has just opened on Broadway?
No.
2 down and 8 to go, Mr. Cerf.
That's kind of a babyish voice. Are you
a baby?
In the younger bracket? By that I mean under 30.
Yep.
Miss Kilgallen?
Do you play nightclubs?
No.
3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Randall.
Are you best known for TV?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
Are you at the present time playing in a TV series?
No.
4 down and 6 to go, Mr. Sir.
Do you ever sing or dance as part of your work?
Yes.
Miss Kilgallen?
Do you make records?
Yes.
Mr. Randall?
But are you primarily a comedian?
No.
5 down and 5 to go, Miss Francis?
You could be.
Yes.
Are you therefore primarily a singer?
Not primarily.
That makes it 6 down and 4 to go, Mr. Sir.
You go from a baby voice to a rather sophisticated one. Are you one of these rock and rollers?
No, not primarily, no.
Well, I think, with your permission, since this does play a part in your identification, we will let that go as a qualified yes, if it's all right with you. All right? Fine. Miss Kilgallen?
Are you a folk singer?
No.
7 down and 3 to go, Mr. Randall.
Have you got a job at the present time?
Oh, that was really
rhetorical question?
Well, yeah. Actually, you didn't mean that as a real question, did you?
I meant, is she currently appearing anywhere? That's what I meant.
I mean, right at the moment,
yes.
Engaged in a...
Something we might see in this locale.
Well, what would I say?
Well, it's a hard question to answer, because if you meant specifically in terms of tomorrow, say, rather than a week from tomorrow, or yesterday instead of a week from yesterday, we'd have to answer one way. If you mean appearing with some frequency, then we would have to say yes, right? All right, Miss Francis?
I don't know where you ended up.
I think she's about to open in a show. That's what I feel is certain.
Yes.
The door is just closing.
Are you about to appear in a play, a musical?
No.
8 down and 2 to go, Mr. Cerf.
Yeah, well, help, Charlie.
Rock and roll, my son has a great favorite, and I'm going to take a chance. Is your first name sometimes used for a boy's name?
Yes.
Joey Heatherton. I just thank my son Chris for this.
Yeah, well,
I'm a friend of your father's.
I'll write Chris a note.
I'm a friend of your father's.
I know.
Well, a lot of us, particularly of Tony's years and my years, remember your dad, who was one of the great pioneers and stars of radio and then in television, Ray Heatherton. And I particularly would like to note that this young lady went down to Santo Domingo with Bob Hope.
That's right.
And she will be going with Bob Hope out to Vietnam this Christmas to entertain our soldiers overseas. And that's great. That's great. And may you have all the success and affection your good father has earned. And may I say you never will travel under better auspices than those of Robert Hope. He's a great, great, great man, as you know.
You're right.
And thank you, Joe. It's
thank
very nice
very
to
much.
Meet you.
Thank you very much.
A splendid recovery panel, so I'll have to give you some congratulations. We'll have another contestant after this word.
Hey, Meg. Ski lessons again this year?
I'll say. I've gotten pretty stale.
Ah, a couple of days in the slopes and you'll be fine.
Cigarettes are tasting pretty stale, too.
Oh? Sounds like you need a change.
Cool.
The only cigarette I smoke.
Your cigarette's not tasting cool enough till you come up to Cools. With Reach Tobacco's Cools White Filter, extra coolness too.
Taste extra coolness as you smoke. Let Cools come through for you.
Now, how's that?
More like it.
You'll be smoking Cools all the time once you come up to Cools.
Come all the way up to Cool and taste the most refreshing coolness you can get in any cigarette. Smoke Cool, Filter Kings.
All right, now to meet our final contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Eleanor Kane, right, ma'am? All right, is it Miss or Mrs. Kane?
Miss.
Miss Kane, where are you from?
New York City.
New York City. All right, Miss Kane, may I present our panel? And if you'll join me over here, why, we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right. Panel, I will admit we're being tricky, and we have... perhaps 3.5 minutes to see what you can do. We'll tell you that Miss Kane is self-employed and deals in a service, and we'll begin with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Could I use your service, Miss Kane?
I think so.
Could Mr. Randall?
Yes.
You're quite sure about him, aren't you?
Reasonably.
Well...
You may be, Miss Kane.
if we had need of your service, would we go to you rather than ringing you up and summoning you?
You would have to take the initiative to utilize the service, yes.
All right. If we took the initiative, would she come to us?
No.
Specifically and in person, no. That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Randall.
It would seem that the majority of your clients are men, is that correct?
No.
No, it would be hard to set an exact figure, but I would say the purpose is that the interest would be both male and female. Miss Francis?
It is a service equally useful to men and women, and you are contacted for this service. Is that what we've arrived at so far?
No, you have to take the initiative
to
get the service.
In order to get the service. If we got the service, is it possible that you or somebody that is in your employ might come to our homes to deliver this service?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
Does the service that you perform, Miss Kane, do people good either mentally or physically?
Excuse me?
You're serving some good either mentally or physically?
I hope so, yes.
Here in the sense of, again, if you require a service and it's satisfactory, you get a sense of well-being. Go ahead, Ben.
Do you buy things for people or advise them in any way?
No, I'd say no.
Four down and six to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Is there anything entertaining about your work?
I would say yes.
You would? Then I would agree with you. Are you in the communications field?
Yes.
Are you in radio?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Randall.
Are you an entertainer?
Not in the sense as it's used. Six down and four to go, Miss Francis.
And you are not in television?
No.
And you are not in the theater?
No.
But you are in communications. Do you have anything to do with the... Is the telephone part of your job?
No.
No. Seven down and three to go, Mr. Sir.
Transportation or tourism, any part of your job.
Eight down and two to go. Well, I'm going to turn the cards over because you're jumping on. What is it, Dorothy?
Is she a writer?
Yes. Right. Good. But more specifically, Dorothy, she's in journalism with you. Miss Kane is a football writer. She writes two football columns, one directed at women to explain football to them, and then she writes for the Football News, which is... a newspaper.
You should explain football to the two New York professional teams.
Yeah, what was the matter with the Giants?
I think we've been on balance. We really stumped them. And congratulations for a unique occupation for a lovely young lady.
Much.
Nice to have you. Once again, Tony, it's nice to have had you with us,
sir.
Thank you. And good night, Dorothy Kilgallen.
Good night, John. Good night, Tony. Please come again.
I will indeed. Thank you. Good night, Arlene, wherever you are.
Here I am. Good night, Bennett, dear.
Good night. I only ought to say one thing about that pretty football writer. She better dig up a field goal kicker for the New York Giants, or it's going to be too bad.
I thought you were going to say something about
a forward
pass.
Good night, John.
Good night, Bennett. Bennett's going to be in Bridgeport this week. Lock the house. And thanks for being with us on What's My Line.
What's My Line is a CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Todner. This is Johnny Olson speaking. Brought to you by Cool, a cigarette with a taste of extra coolness. That refreshing extra coolness you can taste when you come up to Cool Filter King.
That big, big cheese from that famous prep school up in New Hampshire, known to his friends as the Stilton from Tilton, John Charles Day.
Bennett, I'll have a hard time living that down up at Tilton School, but still, I'm going to return kindness for that unkind thrust. We're proud of you because Arlene has already noted that Bennett's new book, Laugh Day, was published 2 weeks ago by Doubleday, but also this week on Thursday, He goes to William Jewell College in Liberty, Missouri, where they're going to give him an honorary doctorate of letters. And congratulations, sir.
Thank you.
Honorary doctorate of jokes they ought to have for you, Bennett.
I'll take that, too.
Of course, we'll have to assume if he's getting an honorary doctorate of letters, he's going to have to learn to write, because I guess you have to write letters. Well, that'll take care of that. Tony Randall, it's a delight to see you again on the panel, and I think that you'll agree when it's all over that we've got an interesting night for you. We're going to have our interesting occupations. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the program. But right now, our first contestant, will you enter and sign in, please? Spoonie. Sink, right, sir? And you can say, you can tell from your dress, sir, and your turban that you are sick, am I right?
That's correct.
You are sick. Could you tell us where you're from now?
I'm from Hollywood.
From Hollywood.
Right.
Well, nice to have you with us. Mr. Singh, may I present our panel?
You do?
And now will you join me over here, sir, and we will let the audience, and that would be the natural expectation, since they sought the service, and having found it, I'm quite sure, satisfactory in every way, they would carry away some sense of well-being.
Is there anything physical about what happens to the people that come to you for your service?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Sir.
Well, Mr. Singh, if there's nothing physical, is there anything mental involved in contact between you and your customers?
I believe so.
There would be some interplay, which we would describe generally, Bennett, as an appreciation of the service that was being bestowed.
Mr. Singh, is anything involving anything like hypnotism or extrasensory perception?
No, there isn't.
Mind reading in
no,
what you do?
No,
that's six down and four to go, Miss Kilgallen.
But, Mr. Singh, you will agree that something does go on that makes these people come to you.
Well, we'll agree there's a good reason for the people to come and utilize the service which Mr. Singh has to offer them.
And yet he is self-employed.
That's right.
So they're not coming to a judge or anything like that. So they come, do they come of their own volition?
Yes, they do.
Are you dressed as you are now when you see them?
On some occasions, yes.
But that doesn't play any part in your work, may I assume that?
At some times it does.
Well, if you don't talk to them, you can't teach them. Do you hand them anything?
No, I don't.
That's seven down and three to go, Mr. Randall.
Is special training required for the performance of your service?
No.
Eight down and two to go, Miss Francis.
Is there anything in any way entertaining about what you do?
I think so.
Is music associated with what you do in any way?
Yes.
Yes, we would agree that there is music in connection. This is not to suggest that.
But it is not that Mr. Singh himself plays a musical
That's right.
instrument.
There's music in connection with it, just a matter of presentation.
When you do what you do, do people watch you?
No.
Mm-hmm, that's a tough one. This raises an area of, we will agree that in the total service involved, there is a, if you will permit this, in the total service involved, watching plays a part, looking plays a part. So you go on that basis.
Is there something therapeutic in your work?
No therapeutics. Nine down and one to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Singh, we've left out animals. Have you anything whatever to do with animals?
Nothing to do with animals, and the panel has been stumped. Mr. Singh owns and operates the Hollywood Wax Museum.
Isn't that part of the entertainment world?
We agreed. We said it was entertainment.
He said it was associated with entertainment.
This is the New York Wax Museum.
This is the New York Wax Museum, right over here on my right. But it's right on Hollywood Boulevard, right?
That's right.
What do you feature in the Hollywood? Is it mostly movie stars, or do you...
About 60% of it is movie stars, and then we've got religious figures, world leaders, and we've got a tremendous horror chamber. That really appeals to the children. That's a variety show. That's about what it is.
Theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right, panel, we can tell you that Mr. Singh is self-employed and he deals in a service, and we'll begin things with Arlene Francis.
Mr. Singh, is your service one that I might enjoy?
I think so.
Does it have anything whatsoever to do with food?
No, it doesn't.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Surf.
Mr. Singh, since you're established in Hollywood, are your services used by the motion picture or television industries at any time?
Sometimes.
But they can also be used by people who are not in those allied arts.
That's
right. Is that
correct? That's right.
Does the service that you perform involve touching people in any way?
No, it doesn't.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Do you speak to them?
Not very often.
Not as a... It isn't necessary.
What kind of an answer is that?
Mr. Singh is antisocial, and it's very nice of him to admit it here, but it's not germane to what he actually does. The service he performs does not require that he speak to
them. That's all right. Give me a no, John.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Randall.
Mr. Singh, you're a remarkably robust man.
Thank you.
Does your powerful physique have anything to do with your services?
No, it doesn't.
Four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
When you perform these services, are you indoors?
Yes.
Do people come to you for your service?
Yes, they do.
Are they better off as a result of your service?
I like to think so.
We would have to agree that in a general sense, this...
To you by Fleischmann's margarine, so light and delicate tasting because it's made from 100% corn oil. And now let's all play What's My Line? And now from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Thank you. On my left, a young man who's just returned from Africa for making a picture called Marrakesh, Mr. Tony Randall.
As ever, it's a joy to introduce the liveliest girl on my block, Arlene Francis.
And now a gentleman who has compiled one of the funniest books of the year. Something in it for everybody to laugh about, and it's called Laugh Day. And the man is Bennett Cerf.
Well, here's...